Very good afternoon to you all. Today we will discuss the power associated with the help of wind. Okay. It means in the input form, the wind will be used, and which type of power, and those type of power, whatever we produce, and those power will be associated from the wind. Okay. And how many type of wind turbines? We will study in further slides. Now here, I would like to tell you about one topic in all those renewable energy resources or non-conventional energy resources. And in renewable energy resources, wind power turbine is one of the most favorable topic. Now here, in this slide, you can see how the wind power originated. Definitely टरबाइन का जनरेशन का कैसे होता है, अगर आपको चीजें पता हो यहाँ देख सकते हैं। Other than what we are discussing the topic, actually this topic is also related to the non-conventional energy resources or the renewable energy resources. Okay, now here let's see. Some type of questions may arise in your question paper, as where does the wind come from? The answers in the suitable form may be like that, and those points are here. The first point is the wind is a byproduct of solar energy. It means what does the point number one says? Point number one says the wind is a byproduct of solar energy. It means the solar energy is the primary concern, and after that the secondary energy source, that is wind energy, wind power we get. That's why the wind is a byproduct of solar energy. Now the next one, approximately 2% of the sun energy is reaching the earth is converted into the wind energy. Now what does the second point say? Second point says whatever the amount of sun light in the form of solar energy reached on the surface, in those amount only 2% of the solar energy will be used for the wind energy. That's why the wind energy is a byproduct of solar energy. Okay. Now point number two is the clarification for the point number one, and what does the point number one says? The wind energy is a byproduct of solar energy. Okay. Now the last point says for the wind energy, wind power, the surface of the earth heats and cools unevenly on the environmental condition, temperature changes. Then creating atmospheric pressure zones that make air flow from high to low pressure areas. You know the where the air flow takes place, it's the air flow from high pressure to low pressure areas. This is very obvious concept for the flow of air. Now here, in the form of wind, in which way we can find the power? The power is that power which comes under the category of NCR, that is non-conventional energy resources. Now, the equation for the wind power may be formulated with the help of this formula. Now the first point is all about this formula. The first point says the amount of power available the wind may be determined in the form of following equation, and what the equation is actually for the new power, W is equal to 1 by 2 R A B to power 3, where W is power, small r is air density, capital A is the rotor area, and V is the wind speed. It means if you will use the formula for the power which is associated with the wind, then we can use this formula. And what is the formula for the energy from the wind? The formula for wind energy is equal to 1 by 2 small r a v q, where these terms are W is power, R is the air density, A is the rotor area, as well as small V is the wind speed. Actually, this equation states some points as the power is equal to the 1 by 2 times of air density times the cube of wind speed air. और सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि जैसे जैसे एयर डेंसिटी वेरी करती है उसी तरीके से एयर डेंसिटी वेरी करती है तो हमको क्या मिलता है उसी तरीके से एनर्जी भी वेरी करती है. नाउ दिस इज वेरी ऑब्वियस दैट वी आर वेरी मच इंटरेस्टेड टू नो दैट हाउ द एयर डेंसिटी चेंजेस. नाउ आई एम टेलिंग यू द एयर डेंसिटी चेंजेस एज the elevation temperature as well as weather changes. Now here you can see the windmill. The windmill is having in the system, and here the wind turbine having some blades, and with the help of wind this one is rotated. After rotating we get some solar energy would be converted in the form of wind energy, and that wind energy will be supplied for the electricity generation. So how many type of wind turbine? Before we discuss the type of wind turbines, we will define the wind turbine. Actually, wind turbine may be defined as a rotary engine, and that engine converts kinetic energy of moving fluid converted into the mechanical energy by causing a blade rotor to rotate. These blades are mounted on the shaft. When the air strikes on the blade, then shaft will also rotate because the blades are mounted on the shaft. And further, now finally we can see the conversion of kinetic energy into the mechanical energy. Wind rotates the turbine blades. That's why the first point one says it spins a shaft connected to a generator. The spin of a shaft in the generator gives electricity. Now, because we get the mechanical power from the wind turbine, and further this would be coupled to the generator. Generator converts that mechanical energy into the electricity. A classification of wind turbine may take place on the behalf of axis orientation. If the axis is horizontal, then the turbine is known as horizontal axis wind turbine. If the axis is vertical, then the wind turbine is known as vertical axis wind turbine. Now, see the horizontal axis wind turbine. What is the introduction of a horizontal axis wind turbine? Here you can see the introduction for the horizontal axis wind turbine. The first point for the introduction in the horizontal axis wind turbine, this is the most common wind turbine design. Okay, this is very obvious design. This is very clear that this was the base for the generation of wind turbine. The second point says, in addition to being parallel to the ground, the axis of blades rotation is parallel to the wind. what we have done in second one. How to provide a parallel geometry to the ground, the axis of plate rotation is designed also parallel to the wind flow. Now, some machines are designed to operate in an upwind mode with the blades upwind of the tower. In this case, other designs is downwind. Horizontal axis wind turbine may be classified on the behalf of number of blades. First one is mono blades, twin blades, triple blades. The maximum number of blades is 3. Either one blade is used in the wind turbine, then that type of blade is known as mono blade. According to the power output, small capacity. In horizontal axis wind turbine, the small capacity ranges from 10 to 50 kW, while the rotor diameter is 1 to 16 meter. For the medium capacity of the horizontal axis wind turbine, that is the 50 to 500 kW, the rotor diameter is 16 to 50 meters. And if we see the large capacity for the horizontal type of axis wind turbine, then the power capacity is from 500 to 1000 kilowatt, rotor dia is 50 to 130 meters. Various types of plates are arranged in a diagrammatic view. Here you can see a single bladed, horizontal axis bladed, double bladed, three bladed, multi bladed. This is the diagram for the upwind, this is a diagram for the downwind. In the upwind, air flows from this direction to this direction, and in the downwind, from air flow in this direction. Types. Here are some forces will be acted for the wind turbine. The horizontal force known as drag force, and the upward force acted, and that name is lift force, and this is the angle of attack. And the horizontal axis wind turbine may have some other types. As you can see here, firstly, the type according to the upwind and downwind turbines. Turbine which face wind stream. एक wind turbine ऐसा जिसका face जो है वो wind के along होता है, ठीक है, विंड स्ट्रीम के सामने होता है. कौन सा हो गया? अपविंड टर्बाइन और एक ऐसा टर्बाइन विच रिसीव्स विंड एनर्जी फ्रॉम रियर साइड और डाउनविंड टर्बाइन. यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं, अपविंड जो है फ्रंट से एयर लेता है और डाउनविंड जो है पीछे से एयर लेता है एज एन इनपुट. फ्रंट वाले को क्या कहते हैं? अपविंड, मतलब फ्रंट से एयर स्ट्राइक करें टर्बाइन को, विंड टर्बाइन को, तो अपविंड, और रियर से स्ट्राइक करें तो डाउन. नाउ द वर्टिकल एक्सिस विंड टर्बाइंस मे हैव सम पॉइंट्स. देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ वर्टिकल एक्सिस विंड टर्बाइन, सेमोनियस विंड टर्बाइंस, डेलियस विंड टर्बाइंस, सेमोनियस विंड टर्बाइंस. इन दिस फिगर यू कैन सी द एक्सिस इज एलोकेटेड वर्टिकली, दैट्स व्हाई this wind turbine is known as vertical axis wind turbine. Now, the Samonius turbine is S-shaped. Here you can see, this is S-shaped. It's one of them. This drag type of vertical axis wind turbine turns relatively slow, but yields a high power. ये स्पीड थोड़ा कम देता है लेकिन टॉर्क ज़्यादा जनरेट करता है, ठीक है. एंड इट इज़ वेरी यूजफुल फॉर ग्राइंडिंग रेन, पंपिंग वाटर एंड मैनी अदर टास्क. इफ द विंड टर्बाइन इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दीज पर्पजेस एज ग्राइंडिंग रेन, पंपिंग वाटर एंड मैनी अदर, देन द वर्टिकल एक्सिस विंड टर्बाइन कैन बी यूज. बट इट इज स्लो रोटेशनल स्पीड्स मेक इट अनसूटेबल फॉर जनरेटिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन के लिए जो है वर्टिकल एक्सिस विंड टर्बाइन सूटेबल नहीं होता है, क्योंकि रोटेशनल स्लो होती है, टर्व ज़्यादा होता है, तो कहाँ पे यूज़ कर सकते हैं, ग्राइंडिंग रेन, पंपिंग वाटर, और इसी तरीके से और सारे जगहों पर यूज कर सकते हैं। बट हियर यू कैन सी द सैबोनियस विंड टर्बाइंस, सैबोनियस VAW2 स्टैंड फॉर वर्टिकल एक्सिस विंड टर्बाइन, मॉडर्न HAW2 हॉरिजॉन्टल। इन सच ऑफ ईयर ब्लेड्स आर डिजाइन फॉर द रेस्पेक्टिव डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ विंड टर्बाइंस। वर्टिकल एक्सिस विंड टर्बाइन हैविंग सम सेकेंड टाइप दैट इज डैरियस विंड टर्बाइंस। व्हाट हैपेंस इन डैरियस विंड टर्बाइंस, एक्चुअली इन डैरियस विंड टर्बाइन इज मोस्ट फेमस VAW. इट इज कैरेक्टराइज बाई इट सी सेप रोटर ब्लेड्स विच गिव्स इट एग बूटर अपीयरेंस। सी सेप रोटर ब्लेड होता है। इट इज नॉर्मली बिल्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ टू और थ्री ब्लेड्स। यहाँ पे देख सकते सी सेप में है। Now, how the construction of wind turbine takes place? If we see the construction part of wind turbine there, here you can see the wind vane is allocated over here. Below this, the needle is allocated over here, and here the high speed shaft is allocated, and the controller is placed over here, and this one is the generator which is mounted on the shaft. Further, this shaft is geared with the help of gearbox, and this gearbox is attached to the low speed shaft, and here the brake, when the situation is under control, then brake can be used, and here the rear drive yaw motors, and for in here is the tower, and this is the blades of the turbine. Here is the wind direction, in which direction wind flows, and here the rotor is attached. On the rotor, the blades are mounted, and this is the pitch of the blades. And further, you can see again the low speed shaft is connected to this rotor, and blades are connected to this rotor also. And here, I would like to tell you about the working of this whole apparatus. Initially, the wind strikes on the blade, and when the wind strikes on the blade, then the low speed shaft will rotate because these blades are mounted on the shaft, and when the shafts will rotate, then what happens? Further, it is connected to the gearbox, and now here the motion is transmitted with the help of gear to the further for the generator, and when the generator receives mechanical energy, then the generator converts the mechanical energy into the electricity. Now our motive is fulfilled of electricity generation, but it should be very clear that the vertical axis wind turbine is not suitable for the electricity generation of first type or second type can be used, but most probably the horizontal type of wind turbine is used for the electricity generation. In the construction part for the vertical axis, ये horizontal का था, vertical axis. Here is the tower. Here is the hub. Hub or shaft. If this is not hollow, then this parts come under the category of hub. And the blades are mounted around the hub. And this is the needle, this is a rotor plate which are mounted on the hub, and these are the parts respectively: brake, generator, high speed shaft, gearbox, low speed shaft, rotor hub. For the motion transmission, basically the gearbox is used for smooth motion. Here you can see the working for different parts. If we see, actually we already discussed to you about the working of the wind turbine. Again, we highlight some terms like rotor. In the rotor section, the hub and the blades together are referred to the rotor. लेफ्ट टर्न्स द प्लेट्स व्हिच टर्न द ड्रिवन शाफ्ट, बता चुके हैं ऑलरेडी। शाफ्ट का क्या काम होता है, टू डिफरेंट शाफ्ट टर्न द जनरेटर, वन इज फॉर लो एंड अनदर इज फॉर हाई। एंड व्हाट इज द गियर बॉक्स, हियर द गियर बॉक्स गियर कनेक्ट टू द हाई एंड लो स्पीड शाफ्ट एंड इंक्रीज द रोटेशनल स्पीड फ्रॉम 10 टू 60 रोटेशनल पर मिनट About 1200 to 1800 RPM. That's why the rotational speed required by most generation to the product could be fulfilled. The generator, basically generator generates electricity with the help of mechanical power. The generator is what converts the turbine's blades into the electricity. Different generator designs produce their alternating current or direct current, and they are available in a large range of output power ratings. Now, what is the work of controller? The controller turns the blades on 8 to 60 amps and shuts them down around 65 to prevent any high wind damages. Now, what is the working of tower? Now, the last is component of wind turbine, that is tower. Tower is basically a tall tabular metal shaft, and this having a motive for the more power production. Okay. Now I would like to thank you. I would like to say many thanks to you that we have covered this topic successfully. If any query is arising in your mind, then just comment in the comment box. 100% I will respond. Have your question to me. Okay. Thank you.